bless your name, Jesus. We bless.
up your hands and just worship the great Adonai. Open up your mouth in your own words, worship the great God. In your own words, open up your mouth and just love on Him this morning. Daddy, we adore you, Lord. We magnify your name. We exalt you. King of glory, ancient of death, the great God, the I am that I am. We worship you this morning. Open up your mouth wherever you're standing this day. Just worship the Lord in your own words. You are wonderful, God. You are great. You are gracious. You are powerful. You are omniscient. You are all-knowing, Lord. We worship you this morning. Let the acceptable worship as a pleasing sacrifice. Holy and acceptable to you, Lord. This morning, Daddy, we come before you with worship in our mouths. Receive our worship. Receive our praise. Father, may you accept it this day. And let all the praise and glory go back unto you. Thank you and thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have praised and worshiped you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's such a lovely morning to see you in the house of the Lord. And I want to assure you that without a shadow of a doubt, you are in the right place at the right time. Praise God. Hallelujah. Very quickly, allow me go to Thanksgiving. And in the same ado, as I'm reading the scripture on Thanksgiving this morning, I want you to kindly and very fast prepare your Thanksgiving offering. Package it well, and make sure it is a pleasing offering unto the Most High God this morning. Today's Thanksgiving scripture is from the book of Psalms 116 and verse 17. And there's that which I want us to do in that scripture. Psalms 116 and verse 17. It says, I will offer to thee the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. I repeat verse 17. It says, I will offer to thee the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. And I will call upon the name of the Lord. Praise God. This morning I want us to do it differently. With your thanksgiving lifted up in your hands, I want you to call upon the name of the Lord this morning. What is it that you want to see from the Lord? Command your thanksgiving offering to bring the answer to you. Praise God. Are we together? In the next few seconds, I will offer to thee the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and will call upon the name of the Lord. With your thanksgiving in your hands, just lift it up, and in your own words, just call upon the name of the Lord. What kind of way do you want to see God manifest in your life and destiny this morning? With your thanksgiving in your hands, just open up your mouth and call upon His name. Lift up your thanksgiving and call upon the name of God this morning. Father, I want to see you in the miraculous. Daddy, I want to see you in a breakthrough. Open up your mouth. Daddy, I want to see you open a new opportunity door. Daddy, I want to see you connect me with destiny helpers. Which way do you want to see God this morning? Lift up your thanksgiving, and according to Psalms 116, call upon His name. Call upon His name. Call upon His name. Daddy, you're the miracle working God. Daddy, you're the answering God. Daddy, you're the mighty man in battle. We want to see you this morning with our thanksgiving offering in our hands. Lord, we ask that you manifest, take the center stage in our lives and destiny, and all the praise and glory go back unto you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Amen.
Amen, amen. I serve a God who is popular. I serve a God who is mighty. His God is a big God, and I call Him a miracle.
masks, eh? When you tell people to give a shout of praise, you can hear as if they are not giving a shout of praise. So kindly, thank you. Give Jesus a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Amen. In all things, we should approach with joy and excitement because we have seen a new week, isn't it? Yes. You have breath of life, isn't it? Yes. There are people in the hospitals with COVID-19 and other diseases. There are people who already by 2020 had so many plans, but they are 6 feet under. Wengine hata walichimbiwa more than 6 feet. Praise God. So every day when you wake up and you're above the ground, it's a day to jubilate, it's a day to be happy, it's a day to give thanks to God, it's a day to be joyful. And so with a clap offering, give Jesus a loud more shout of praise. Hallelujah. Praise God. And I'm excited to see you. My heart and Papa's heart is ever full when we see you in the house of the Lord. You may have your seat in the presence of the Almighty God as you sit on the necks of your enemies permanently. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Wave to your neighbor on the right, on the left, in front of you, behind you, and furthermost in front, that is me. Praise God. And I'm glad to see you once again. Feel at the feet of Jesus. I can assure you this service today is loaded with the presence of the Almighty God. The servant of God was virtually the whole night awake, waiting on the Lord for this service. And I know without a shadow of a doubt, you will not go the same way you came. 30 minutes in the presence of the Lord is more than enough for God to change your lives and transform it a 360 degree turnaround. Can I hear believers? Amen. If you believe that 30 minutes in the presence of God is massive, God can turn your life around. Can I hear a bigger amen? And announcements, I go very quickly to the announcements today. Kindly let me pass this on to you. Because of time, we might keep on forgetting some important things like testimonies. If you know without a shadow of a doubt that you have a testimony, kindly when you come on Sunday, look for Pastor Eric or any one of the pastors and just tell them, I have a testimony. Sometimes we might forget to announce it in front here, and that time you're seated there with a testimony. Are we together? So just put it within yourself. You know you have a testimony. Don't wait to hear the announcement. Immediately you're in church, look for one of the pastors and tell them, I have a testimony. They will direct you to the person in charge that day with the testimonies. Praise God. Do you have any? All right. Announcements. Announcements of the day is Sunday service. We are here. Amen. Hallelujah. Every Sunday from 11 to 12 noon, we usually have our Sunday services, and that is why we are gathered here this morning, and you're welcome. On Monday services, we have them. They begin from 6:30 to 7:30 here at the Lord City. We don't have town services anymore because of space, all right? So on Wednesday, again, we have the breakthrough and communion service, which is usually here again on these grounds, the Lord City. Praise God. The Lord City is the venue that will be having all our services, because suddenly, because of the COVID and the, you know, the spacing and everything, Olympic House seems to be small. So Wednesday communion is here again, 6:30 to 7:30 in the evening. Make sure you're here on time, since it's a short service. On Friday, the prophetic service is usually here. Thursday services are not fully back, but last week we had a Thursday service because of the conference that was going on. For those that were blessed with the conference, let me see your wave up in the air. Amen. It was a powerful conference, and we give thanks and all the glory to the Almighty God. Praise God. And PhD, Prayer, Healing, and Deliverance, on the month of August, will be on 30th of August. Are you excited for that service? It will be a 1 hour marathon of the prophetic, of the healing, and of deliverance. So make sure you note it down somewhere that day. We will finish service and then release those who are going. Then we go to the PhD immediately. I'm sure some of you are feeling lacking here and there because of the limitation of the time. So make sure you're there for the prophetic healing and deliverance, your word and your healing, and you will be delivered in that very day. That is on the 30th of August, the last Sunday of this month. Ladies of Royal Distinction monthly meetings will be here on the 22nd of August. That is the third. Yes, thank you. That is a very loyal Lord woman. Praise God. So the meetings will be here on the 22nd of August. That is the third Saturday of this month. And I believe as women, the Lord will minister to us in a different and in a new way, in Jesus' mighty name. Online services are on every Monday, every Wednesday, and every Friday. It's such a sacrifice that Papa lives here and goes home to do another online service from 8 p.m. to 9. So make sure you tune. So on Monday, he's online again after the service here. He's online again with the service from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Make sure you tune in. Make sure you like, love, and you share. On Wednesday, the same, 8 to 9 p.m. And on Friday is when we have our mini Kesha. Praise God. When the devil tries to come on this way, we go the other way. Praise God. He thought that we will not have Keshas. As Sound of Abundance, we are having Keshas every Friday. Praise God. Is that not a wonderful thing? And last Friday was awesome. So we have a mini Kesha every Friday from 12 a.m. to 2 a.m. every Friday with Daddy. Praise God. Appointments are on bookings. Make sure if you want to see Papa tomorrow, see Pastor Eric after the service, or grab his number that you may be able to book. And if you're coming with any other person, remember to top it up and tell him that I'll be coming with an extra person. Otherwise, you will come here, and if your name is not on the list, you'll not be able to see the man of God, and I'm sure it will not be very nice, right? So let's follow protocol. Let's do things as they ought to be done, and then the Lord will richly and increasingly bless us in Jesus' mighty name. Wisdom capsule, word of the week by our daddy in the Lord, Reverend B. Akama. Are you ready with your notebooks, your pens? You're ready to write it down. Wisdom capsule by our daddy in the Lord. And many a times we write these wisdom capsules and we never share them. I hope you apply them in your life in one way or the other. But the reason as to why we share these wisdom capsules every Sunday is that you may make your social media handles useful. Many things are shared on WhatsApp and every other place that do not make sense. But when we share this kind of wisdom capsules, you share them and you spread Jesus on your social media handles. So the wisdom capsule today states, remember every lesson you learn in life and make sure you don't forget, or else you will find yourself learning the same lesson again. I repeat again, remember every lesson you learn in life and make sure you don't forget, or else you will find yourself learning the same lesson again. I repeat the third and the last time, remember every lesson you learn in life and make sure you don't forget, or else you will find yourself learning the same lesson again. I believe I'm talking to good students who don't repeat classes. And that is exactly what that wisdom capsule is telling us this morning. Every lesson that you learn in life, be it a good lesson, be it a mistake, it should be able to take you to the next classroom. Praise God. When you repeat a classroom, that means when you repeat a mistake, or when you repeat another thing that was not very profitable to you, it means you never learned the lesson. And so Papa is telling us this morning through the wisdom capsule that you should remember every lesson you learn in life or else you will find yourself repeating the same class. And with God, He's always willing to make you repeat that class. Praise God. And it's applicable in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Can I hear an amen? You will make every lesson applicable positively in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And without ado, I kindly request you to rise up on your feet. We are about to hear the word of God. I want you to rise up on your feet with an expected heart, with an expected spirit. Lift up your hands and just begin to talk to God in your own words. What is it that you want to hear from His servant this morning? Open up your mouth and just begin to minister to Him. Just begin to minister to Him in your own words, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your hands with an expected heart. Lift up your hands and minister to God with an expected heart. Open up your mouth. From this service, what do you want to go home with this wonderful morning? Open up your mouth and just speak to God in Jesus' name.
Nachotaka niwe, niwe wetu. Nachotaka niwe, niwe wetu. Chama ya moyo wangu ni Yesu. Chama ya moyo wangu ni Yesu tu. Nachotaka niwe, niwe, niwe. Nataka niwe, niwe, niwe. Chama moyo wangu ni Yesu. Chama ya moyo wangu ni Yesu tu. Nachotaka niwe,
nachotaka niwe.
Yeah.
thank you for receive all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Just go with me in the book of Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes, if you have your Bible, Ecclesiastes chapter 8. Ecclesiastes chapter 8. We take it from verse, give it verse 11. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 11. Hallelujah. Ecclesiastes. Kindly look up for a minute. It says, because sentence. My Bible says, because a sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily, therefore the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil. Go back. It says, because a sentence against an evil work, let me say this, we have so many wicked people. Are you with me? And when I talk about wicked people, I'm not talking about witches. Leave them. Those are not them. Their level of which wickedness is another level. I'm talking about people, human beings. We have so many wicked people. People that don't feel anything oppressing others. People that don't feel anything hurting others. Bible says, because a sentence against an evil work, somebody does evil to you and they know there's nothing you can do about it. Bible says their evil work is not executed speedily, therefore the heart of the sons of man continue doing evil. Somebody continues to be like a devil just because they know there's nothing you will do about it. Today we'll do something about it. Are you with me? One day a lady told another lady, I will take your husband and let's see what you'll do about it. A lady was working and her boss told her, a supervisor, I will make sure you're sacked and there's nothing you will do about it. Those are wicked people. Are you with me? Bible says their sentence against their evil work needs to be executed speedily. The only way to stop a wicked man is when they see vengeance. Are you with me? When they see what? My God fighting for me. The truth is this, sometimes there's nothing you can do about it, but there's everything God can do about it. We are going to pray three prayers. And I want you to pray from your heart. Oh Lord, anyone doing me evil, let your sentence be executed on their lives speedily. Are you with me? If it is in your office, it is in your home, wherever, whoever is doing you evil. Paul says, Alexander the coppersmith has done me evil, but the Lord will recompense him. The Lord will pay him. Say, my father, your voice is not loud. Say, my father,
my father, my father.
Any
man or woman,
in my house,
in my house,
in
my office,
at my place of work,
at my place of
that
work, that is doing me evil.
Oh Lord,
let your judgment
be executed upon them. Quickly. In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of
Open
Jesus.
Your mouth and pray.
My Father.
Open your mouth and
my
pray.
Father.
Leave that house.
doing evil against my life.
Open your mouth.
Against my wife.
Anyone in my office.
My place,
anyone in my business. That has done me evil. Execute judgment. Execute judgment. Repo papa yegega. Zigegegege regepa. Itetetete repaga. Zigidiyankalapa. Repo papa ekete. Iketulabaya. Open your mouth and pray. Yadiyado baragina. Le papo sagadina. Zigegerando sadaba. Rekoprakate sekitolodiana. Open your mouth. Whoever is doing me evil, whoever has done me evil, let judgment over their lives be executed speedily. Open your mouth and pray. In Jesus' name we pray.
A lady one time came to me, said, "Man of God, pray for me, I'm depressed." I said, "What is the problem?" He said, "I have 3 children and my husband kicked me out of the house." I said, "Why?" He said, "Because my mother-in-law and my sisters-in-law don't want me. So they came and they chased me." "Man of God, I'm struggling with the children." I asked her a question, "What did you do to your in-law?" He said, "Nothing." And she told me, "Even if I did anything, don't I deserve forgiveness?" He said, "May God fight for me." Child of God, don't be deceived. We have people whose heart is callous. Their heart is wicked. Very wicked. And a wicked man, you don't say, "God bless you." Let vengeance speak. Let God give them hypertension. Give his love. Let God suck them. Let corona eat their lungs. Listen, people must know we serve a living God, though. You cannot just touch me and you go cut free. My God will pay for me.
Amen.
I say, "My God will pay for me."
Amen.
So my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Now listen to me. This prayer, I want you to be very direct. If you know anyone who has done evil to you or is oppressing you, we are going to call their name.
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
I believe in war.
Yes.
Bible says, "Peace cometh not, lest by war." There are people, if they don't die, you can never have rest. Are you with me? Let me tell you the truth. They are wicked. They will sack you and you have done nothing and they won't feel anything. They will fight you until you go down and they will feel nothing about it. Amen. If you know them, you will call their 3 names if you can. And let that God, in the next 24 hours, in the next 7 hours,
yes,
God, let your vengeance strike.
Amen.
Say, "My Father, my Father, any man or woman that has done me evil, that has done evil to me, oh Lord, in 24 hours, in 7 hours, execute judgment speedily." Open your mouth and pray. Lade Baraga, if you know your name, mention their name. Lady Gabra Sotopa, Igetedia, Rupe Papalico, Zikegera Parada, Atitula Paria Geraske Topa. Open your mouth and pray. Seven days, 7 hours. Lord, let them know that my agreement legal. Open your mouth and pray. Libre de tous aujourd'hui à Paranas. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, "My Father, my Father, any man or woman that has done me evil and they
in the next 7 hours, in the next 24 hours, let them know that I serve a living God. Father, fight for me. Open your mouth and pray. Let them know I serve a living God. Let them know I serve a living God. Let them know I serve a living God. In 7 hours, in 24 hours, let them know I serve a living God. Let them know. Ekabaragadibus.
I serve a living God in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, let them know I serve a living God.
In Jesus' name we pray. Put us together, believing God, it is settled. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' name we pray. You may have your seat in the presence of the Father. We thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Very fast, this is our month of commanding a turnaround. This is our month of commanding a turnaround. And I said, if you have been on one spot for long, if you have been in your life, there are no testimonies. If your life has no breakthroughs, if nothing is working in the corridors of your life, if you have nothing to show, if you have been stagnant, if your life is just dormant and normal, then you need to know at that particular moment, you need a turnaround. When things are not moving the way you expect, or your prayers are not being answered at the speed or at the frequency of your desire, then you need a turnaround. Today I want to talk about how do you command a turnaround. There are 4 ways you command a turnaround in your life. Bible says in the book of Psalms 126 verse 1 to verse 5. He said, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Our mouths were filled with laughter and our tongue with singing. Then they said among the heathen, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, like the streams in the south. He says, they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. And them that carry precious seed, verse 6, he that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come back rejoicing with the sheaves with him. So he says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, meaning God has capacity to change your captivity. God can bring a turnaround. See, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Then our mouths were filled with laughter. Turn around brings laughter. When things are not going right, and then now God overturns them, then the first thing that happens, laughter and joy comes. The second thing that happens is that people start noticing that something good is happening in your life. So they said among the heathen, the Lord has done great things for them. The importance of a turnaround is that it gives you a testimony. You are only the one testifying, but also people testify about it. I pray in this month of August that God will cause people to testify about what he's doing in your life. Child of God, it's important you enjoy a turnaround. Every child of God, when nothing is working the way you want them to work, what you need to do is to pray for a turnaround. Praise the name of the Lord. How do you command a turnaround? I'll give you one. There are 4. God helping us, we'll finish it in between the week. One way you command a turnaround is through praise. You make sure you're a man or a woman of praise. Where there is no praise, there is a decadence. There is things die. Anytime you don't praise, you cannot be raised. Praise is the stairway of rising up. Praise the name of the Lord. God only responds to praise. God does not respond to complaining. That is why if you want a quick response to God's prayer, praise him. Tell him you're Jehovah Almighty. There's no one who rules in heaven with you. You are God who sits in heaven.
and controls the affairs of man. You are the one that walks on the wings of the cloud. You are the one that stretches the heavens like curtain, and you make the inhabitant look like grasshopper. Tell God, I've never seen a man like you. You created the universe and nobody created you. And as you begin to praise God, then you begin to see the supernatural intervention of God. In the book of Habakkuk chapter 3 verse number 17, the devil has given us a song. It's called the song of murmuring and complaining. Why, when, where? Many people today, nobody is thanking God for their lives. Child of God, do you know every day people are dying because of this satanic disease called COVID? You have been going to work every day, is it not so? You have been going to a business place. Some of you have been busy, but look at the way God has protected you. Can I ask you a question? Do you think that mask can help you? I'm asking a question. Do you think sanitizing can help you? Unless the Lord builds a city, the builders build in vain. Child of God, is because the hand of God is upon you. That's why this thing has not come upon you, and it shall not come upon you. Dear Mars, Habakkuk chapter 3 verse 17. You must come to a place whereby your mouth is full of thanksgiving. When you're full of thanksgiving, then you begin to see the supernatural manifestation of God's grace. Bible says, though the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall the fruit be found in the vine, the labor of the olive shall fail, and the fields shall not yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Verse 18. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the Lord, in the God of my salvation. Then what will happen? The Lord my God is my strength. So strength comes, and it will make my feet like hinds' feet, and it will make me to walk upon the high places. He says, when I begin to thank God and praise Him, God begins to lift me and I begin to walk on high places. Child of God, why are you low? I've always said you cannot serve the Most High and remain the most low. The only antidote for you going up and never coming down is your mouth must be full of thanksgiving. There must be praise in your mouth. Am I communicating? True things are tough. True things are not working. True systems are under pressure. But if you can learn to praise God in that situation, God will bring a turnaround. I pray may the Lord give you a turnaround in the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, they were going to battle. Bible says they were going to battle, they began to sing. How do you sing, 2 Chronicles 20 verse 12? They began to sing. How do you sing when there is battle in front of you? The best way and the cheapest way to win any battle of life, make sure your spirit is agile, full of praise. It is true, things around you might not look like it, but praise God. Bible says, are you there? 2 Chronicles 20 verse 12. Our God will not judge them. Give me verse number 15 because of time. He said, hearken ye all Judah, an inhabitant of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus says the Lord unto you, be not afraid, nor be dismayed, by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Verse 16, tomorrow go ye down against them. Behold, they shall come up at the cliff of Ziz, and shall find them at the end of the brook, before the wilderness of Jeruel. Ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Why? Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Then what is the procedure? Verse 18. And Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. The next verse. And the Levites of the children of the Kohathites and the children of the Kohites stood up to praise the Lord, God of Israel, with a loud voice on high. They were going to battle. The company, the multitude was bigger than them. But the only way they could conquer the battle, it was this. Joseph had bowed his head. When he finished worshiping, he began to arrange singers and the Levites, and they began to praise God with a loud voice. Child of God, what are you going through now? Go to your house and lift your voice and praise God. You will see a turnaround coming into your life. The next verse. And they rose early in the morning and went forth in the wilderness of Tekoa. as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God and it shall be established. Believe his prophet and it shall prosper. Verse 21. And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that should praise the beauty of his holiness. They were not going to ask God intervene in our battle. He said, no, let's praise the beauty of his holiness. Let's tell him the Lord lives. Let's tell him the Lord, you are holy and there's no one like you. Let's begin to praise his greatness. Let's begin to praise how beautiful he is. Let's forget that there's a battle ahead. Matter of fact, we are marching towards the battle. But this is what must be in your mouth, praise. As they were doing that, listen to me. Anytime you worship, God sends angels. Anytime you praise, God comes by himself. The reason why you have not seen God yet, your praise is not full. Your praise is not full. You are praising God, but you have murmuring inside. You are praising, but you're considering your battle. They began to praise the beauty of his holiness. They were talking about how holy God is. How beautiful is his presence. They were thanking God for, they were magnifying him. God said, I like what I hear. Child of God, is nothing that tingles the ears of God like sweet words from the mouth of his saints. When you tell God how beautiful he is, if you remind him of his great works, Bible says that Moses was told by God, you shall teach your children's children this song, how God delivered you out of Egypt and his mighty power upon Pharaoh. God likes to be magnified. If God was in Kenya, he could have come from South Nyanza. Because he likes to be praised. Am I communicating here? Learn that even if you're going through battle, praise God. Because when you do that, obviously they began to sing. And the Lord heard it. And the Lord went ahead of them and set an ambushment. God did not send angels. When you worship well, angels are dispatched. But when you praise well, God comes by himself. Because the Bible says in Psalm 22 verse 3, God inhabits the praises of his people. Where God hears praise, he does not send an angel. He comes by himself. And I've always said God does not come as a person. God comes as a person. I pray for somebody today that as you begin to praise God, you will experience a turnaround. The children of Israel went into the mount of battle. They came back with spoil. They came back with treasures. They did not fight that battle. Why? Because Jehoshaphat taught them the secret of winning the battles of life. One way you win the battles of life, child of God, learn to praise God. Am I communicating here? Very fast, what is in praise? When you praise, then what is in praise? Number one thing that is in praise, God himself is in praise. Psalms 22:3, God inhabiteth the praises of his people. God himself, but thou, O art holy, O thou that inhabitest the praises of Israel. When God hears praise, God is excited. Child of God, is an insult to divine blessing. If you come to church and you cannot dance, you move your body like a iroko tree. You feel as if we're disturbing you. Child of God, the only time you need to experience the supernatural hand of God. Amen. Listen to me. There's no situation God cannot change. When God enters into your situation, it is a guarantee there will be a turnaround. I like what Luke chapter 1 verse 37 says. It says, for with God, nothing is impossible. So if you are able to bring God through praise in your situation, nothing shall be impossible. Bible says, for with God, Jeremiah 32 verse 17. He said, for God, with you, nothing is impossible. Jeremiah 32 verse 17. So anytime, aha, Lord God, behold, thou art made the heavens and the earth by thy great power and stretch out arm, and there's nothing too hard for thee. When you bring God through praise, there's nothing too hard. If it's a baby you're looking for, there's nothing too hard for God. If it's a job you want, there's nothing impossible for God. Let me tell you something. In this situation and this season, where people are crying and people are wallowing in lack, if you learn to praise God, you will ride on the high places of the earth. Am I communicating here? Somebody shout amen. Praise is one invitation God cannot turn down. Praise is one invitation God cannot turn down. Anytime you praise him, it shows up. I want to urge you to have a system. I call it a praise system. have a praise system. You have a prayer system. You have warfare system. Learn to have praise system. There's something we call praise fair. There's warfare and praise fair. Whereby you decide for the next 30 minutes, the next 5 minutes, I'm going to dance like a madman. When David saw how God had killed one of Ahaz, one of his men, God, David was angry with God, and he took the Ark of the Covenant, which was carrying the blessings for David, and he took it in the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite. Obed-Edom knew this Ark of the Covenant is God himself, and God has come into my house. Obed-Edom began to praise God, and was in 3 months, Obed-Edom was blessed. Do you know what? God blessed Obed-Edom the Gittite until David had. What kind of blessing is that in 3 months that made the king say, I'm going for the ark? Obed-Edom became greater and he was a servant. Obed-Edom became greater than David. In wealth, he became greater. When David heard about it, he said, gather people together. I know the formula of bringing God to Jerusalem. The Bible says he placed singers and the Levites, and they began to blow trumpets and they began to sing. As they were going, obviously they went, David began to dance, and David was dancing. They took the Ark of the Covenant. As they were coming back, they were dancing again. The wife Michal was watching. Say, what kind of nonsense is this? Do you know what? Praise looks like nonsense. They were saying, what, a whole king, a whole man with dignity, a whole man wearing crown is dancing before young girls? What is he showing us? Look at this, dancing at his clothes are tearing. Look at this man. And then when they were finished, the wife said, I will handle you. You know, women have a tendency of handling the man in the bedroom. David came to change. He was like, I bless his people. When he entered his chamber, the wife caught him. A whole man like you, you are misbehaving before people. Look at the way you are misbehaving. And David said, it's because of this that God preferred me than your father. Saul never praised God once. His kingdom and his tenure was reduced. David said, because of this. And he said, I'll be more undignified than this. I'll be more vile than this. Child of God, stop your philosophy. Stop your high-mindedness. Stop your big attitude. Create time for praise fair. Make sure you have every day, you have a moment to praise God. There are 3 ways you praise God. One, you praise God with words of acclamation. You praise God with the words of acclamation. You tell him of his wonders. Before you say anything, begin to adore him. Tell him you're wonderful. Remind him of where he has taken you from. Remind him of his great things he has done in your life. Words of acclamation. Speak, tell him you're wonderful. You're the king above all kings. We call you Jehovah Medishkenu. You are God who is a fighter. God, you have kept me alive because you're Jehovah my provider. I have not lacked food because you have sustained me. Lord, I slept and I woke because thou sustained me. Words of acclamation. Don't stop starting. And the first thing you wake up is die by fire. What are you killing? Sometimes the best thing to do is to rise up with words of acclamation. Begin to praise God. Tell him of his wonders. Speak of his goodness. Remind him, if it was not by his hand, your enemies could have swallowed you. Child of God, that's the best way to secure the hand of God. When you begin to tell God of what he has done, remind him. When David was confronted with Goliath, he did not say, you will see, you will know me. No, he said, God delivered me from the hand of the bear. He delivered me from the hand of the lion. When God had it, he said, yes, even this time, I will deliver you. Your problem is this, the words in your mouth. I am tired. I am tired. I am discouraged. Oh, my friend, there's no time for that. That has never brought God in anyone's situation. The best way to bring God into your picture, when you want to see divine intervention, make sure there are proper words of acclamation. Am I communicating? I was trying to teach my children how to serenade their mother. Amen. 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 Let me not tell you what we do behind the scene. Anytime I mention those words, mama will have to smile. I wanted her to go and change me. Amen. Change me. Amen.
Amen.
So you change children. Don't you change your children? Do you change in a diaper? I wanted to be changed. So I was wearing my clothes. I wanted to be changed. Ah, see, good over here. I said, you're beautiful. Look at how beautiful you are. Beautiful women don't say. After I said good words, I was being changed in a hurry. Good words attract favor. Child of God, the problem with you, you want the hand of God, but the problem is you're not willing to speak good words to God. Remind him of his wonders. Is there a day God delivered you from fire? Is there a day God delivered you from the place that could have consumed you? Did you meet with an accident and God evaded it? Praise him for that. When you start telling God with words of acclamation, reminding him he's the King of Kings and of Lords, what you will see is the hand of God. Some of you, oh, I'm struggling. Hey, Corona is wicked, has dealt with us. Child of God, it will attack you. Am I communicating? The ones I know, four men of God have died because of COVID. I entered my prayer room, I began to thank God. He said, God, every Tuesday I pray for people lining up. Over 20, 30 people. God, you have protected me. It's not because sometimes mama feels I'm very careless. Sometimes I'll forget my mask. But listen to me. When I go, when I kneel down before, I say, God, I need this. I'll take 15 minutes to adore him. I'll tell him of his wonders. How his divine protection and hedge is upon me. Child of God, you can never be safe. The only God can keep you safe. You can never be safe enough. Only God keeps you safe. Am I talking to you? Am I communicating here? Words of acclamation. Number two. How do you praise God to bring God in your situation? One is what? Words of acclamation. Number two is you must have an attitude of gratitude. Be happy. Rejoice over his wonders. Rejoice. Bible say rejoice. And again I say rejoice. Have an attitude of gratitude. Always be happy. Stop being gloomy. Appreciate God for life. Be happy with today. You say, oh God, it's another Monday. Hey, another week. Oh, hey. No. Wake up happy, full of life. Be happy for that day, thanking God for that day. Thank God for the day you have seen. Your eyes were open. There's no machine on your body. Child of God, you're fine. Everything around is well. Wake up happy. That's one way you give. God say, this one is grateful for life. This one is grateful that her face can put makeup. Do you know there are people who must put makeup every day because they have no, their natural skin is damaged, but your own is fine. Wake up with a heart of be happy. Number three, be glad to be in his presence. Always look for an opportunity to be in his presence. There's something that God loves, people have never known. God loves those who appear before him in his house. Stop excuse. No, Tuesday is very far. You know, Thursday or Wednesday before I beat traffic. When God sees you're willing to be there, David said, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of God. Be excited anytime you are meant to come into the house of God. Be excited to be in church. Stop this excuse that you have. Oh, you know, it is not safe. Oh, you know, nonsense. Be happy to be in his house. When you're in his house, you meet his divine power. Am I communicating? Number four, make sure there's a dance. A song of dance. Make sure there's a song of praise. Make sure there's a dance. We will say, praise the Lord with the dance. Psalms 149, verse number 3. It said, praise the Lord with the dance. People are giving offering thanksgiving. I was looking around. People are not dancing. Child of God, you have never had a problem with your hip bone. You have never had a problem with your waist. If the day you cannot shake it anymore, you will know the importance of your waist being light. Am I communicating here? If your legs can still bend, praise God with them. You don't know what it means when you cannot stretch one part of your body. People are praising God. You're standing there. You're looking around. You're looking around. You're forgetting that if God wants that body to praise him. Dance. Have praise fair. Make sure you have a time in your house. Put music. Dance a little. Dance to the glory of God. Some of you have funny things you listen to. Create time to praise God. Put music and dance. Am I talking? Not only in church. Please learn how to dance. Learn it. Learn how to be in your house. Yes, it is true. Matter of what they say, it's very therapeutic. Make sure there's a song of praise. Put praise. Add some volume. Dance a little. Enter your shower. Just before you open the, you release the water. Dance for 5 minutes. Say, God, this dance is for you. There's something I saw in Nigeria. There's a season in their life. They call it Thanksgiving season. It's always in December. Every church plus Catholic, the whole day, there's no preaching. The whole day, it is dancing and praise. People will come per family. People will come per family. They are coming with the dance. Every family is given 5 minutes just to praise God for the whole year. It is in Kenya every Thanksgiving. People go to the village. They don't know the importance of annual Thanksgiving. I saw it in Nigeria, I loved it. I was in a place called in a place in Delta State, and I saw people were doing it. People were dancing, people were sweating. I asked the pastor, why are they dancing? And he said, they are thanking God the whole year. They have not died. The whole year, their family is intact. Do you know how many people today are crying? I was watching something on the on TV during news time. I discovered somewhere they are bringing this issue. Oh, you know, August 11th. Oh, you know, bomb blast. And I said, all these people have come here. They have come to mourn people who have died. And one lady said, there are people who even they their loved one died and they died. They're no longer here. Hello, God, thank God. I saw that thing in Nigeria. I said, we do the sound of God. The whole day we come to dance. Are you hearing me? We just come to praise God. Child of God, you see miracles you've never seen before. God said, if you can create time to dance for me, I will show you I can create time to bless you. If you're too busy for God, he will make his angels too busy for you. Child of God, have time in your house. Have time to put praise and dance. Don't dance for anything. Dance to thank God. Dance to praise God. But when you start doing that, God overturns things for you. God overturns things. Praise when you enter. And I want you to learn it. Because I already did that. In your house, make sure every day or thrice a week, every Monday before I go to work, I'll wake up 5 minutes before. I will put music. You're the one who pays rent. Say, God, as I praise you, I thank you because you give my own. Please, 5 minutes, dance. Dance. Some of you dance for the devil for how many years? Before you go to say, how many years? You're not talking because you know some of you are majors in this thing. One day a lady asked me, Papa, you tell us to dance. Me, the only dance I know is the club dance. The one I know is the one who used to dance the club. After which one is that? He said, Papa, you know what I mean. Some of you could dance for the devil until you put your head down and you speak with your head though. You're coming to church, the King of Kings who saved you. You're saying like this. Thunder will strike you. Dance! Then if it's dance, unas to an end, dance! There are times, sometimes, in my excitement time, I'll put music. I'll bring my three people, say, oh, yeah, let's dance. Let's celebrate life. One day, God gave us a miracle, Mama and I, were in our bedroom. We were naked. We were just from taking shower. We were naked, amen? And when the breakthrough came, we put song, naked, we began to dance. Don't imagine it, just don't forget it. We were dancing. Bible said they were naked and not ashamed. We were in a geogopa. You are two of us. She's not my wife. She's my wife. Naked, you were dancing. Hey, it didn't take long. Another breakthrough came. Am I talking? Amen. Mama, when you go home, tell your husband, remove clothes. You're going to dance. It must be your husband, though. Amen. Do you know how it takes for one breakthrough to come? Amen. We are busy talking about some things. We are very busy discussing. You know those wicked manners of women. Yes, yes. Then, bam, phone call came. Apa? Aja kuniangalia hivyo na wewe dance. One time, after I go with my phone to the bathroom, put music. I dance in on the shower. Say, yeah. I enjoy my life. Sir, my kidneys are fine. My lungs are fine. My brain is correct. My head is correct. My blood is flowing well. There's no cancer anywhere. Is it not enough to dance for God? Are you waiting for Donald Trump will become your husband for you to praise God? Dance! When you do that, you bring God in. You bring God. Do you know even angels cannot dance? Their work is to worship. So God, when he sees people dancing, say, hey, this one don't have it in heaven here. Here is, we bow before you, holy, holy. He said, when I see dance, I get excited. Amen. Bible said, one day Jesus went to the market and he saw children. And Jesus gave a parable, say, I came to the market and I saw children playing flute. I played flute, did not dance. He said, if you don't praise me, these stones, I'll raise them just to praise me. Child of God, if you want to see a turnaround in any area, praise God. Praise God. I don't know if I'm talking. Number two, what is in praise? As I come to my close, what is in praise? Revelation. Revelation. You can say divine insight. Lord, what do I need to do to come out of this situation? Divine insight or revelation. God will reveal to you what to do. Deuteronomy 29:29. Secret things belong to God, but the revealed one are for us and our children. There are things that God has for us. Secret things belong to God, but those things which are revealed belong to us and our children forever, that you may do all the words of this law. Secret things belong to God. Am I communicating? In Psalms 119 verse 164, three times a day I will pray, and seven times I will praise you. Psalms 169, 119 verse 164. Learn to praise God. The app 164, Psalms 119 verse 164. Seven times a day do I praise thee because of thy righteous judgment. Seven times. David was praising God seven times a day. The question is, how many times do you praise God a day? That's why David became a king. Every battle David went, he won. David never died in battle. He died of old age. Other kings plus Saul died in battle. But David knew seven times. Sometimes in the middle of the battle, David could turn on praise because my seventh time has not arrived. How many times do you praise God? Say, seven times I will praise you. Seven times a day. You spend 7 days complaining. That's why your situation is not changing. That's why you're still single. The day you start thanking God for your husband, that's the time you'll see him come. Start thanking God. Thank God with the little money you get. See how God will multiply it. Bible says Jesus took two fish and five loaves, lifted up. He did not pray for increase. He thanked God and God multiplied. Sir, what is the secret of multiplication? Thanksgiving. Learn to praise God. Am I communicating? Seven times. Papa, things are not working for me. It's none of my business. Go into thanksgiving. Say amen. Papa, my house will be locked. It's okay. Thank God for it. You'll be surprised. Which landlord is not under the greater landlord? The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Revelation. Lord, what do I need to do? Last night I was in the presence of God from around 1 a.m. I was not praying for anything. I was thanking God for everything. When I went to my bed at 3:30 in the morning, my mouth was full of thanksgiving. Yesterday I didn't pray, oh God, heal them. No, I was thanking God. I was thanking God. I was thanking God. In this time, I sat down with another man of God, and they began to lament to me how things have been hard for him. How things have not been working since March. The man of God, I've left ministry for now. I am doing business. Another man told me, I cannot go back to church. I've opened an hotel. It's not working for me. I looked at him. Another one told me, man of God, not everybody is affected. I smiled. I said, not everyone is affected. Me, I was not affected. Why? Because I've learned before I do anything. Bible says, be anxious for nothing but in everything by prayer. And what? Supplication. Let your request be unto God and the peace of God. Philippians 4:6 says, be anxious for nothing but in everything by prayer. With thanksgiving. With what? Thanksgiving. I make sure my first 15 minutes, I thank God. The next 30 minutes, I pray in tongues. When I enter the chambers of asking for things, God delivers quickly. Why? I have a system. I have a system. That was a prayer at all times with thanksgiving. You thank God. Create time. Create time to thank God. Create time. Please, please, time in your house. Dance. These are things that look very stupid, but they have a great impact. If you saw me last night, you will know Papa is a witch doctor. Papa is a witch. I began with worship, then I praised. I only put praise on my song, on my phone. I was dancing at 2 a.m. Amen. I was sweating at 2 a.m. Alone. Amen. Mama is snoring this side. So I'm snoring this side. But I'm praising God. Alone. Chai. Show me where, how I'll be broke. It's not possible. I follow biblical principles to stand on top. Biblical principles, sir. Biblical principles. You want to complain? You're welcome. You want to lament? More grace. You want to cry? More tears. You want to whine? More grace. You want to complain? God give you more grace. But as for me, I will praise God. Job said, though he slays me, yet I will praise him. I will praise him. Am I talking? That is what commands a turnaround. That's what commands a turnaround. My business is low. Don't worry. Go to the shop. Close it a little. Put music. Nobody knows what you're doing. My friend, shake it. Move. Are you talking to me? To the glory of God. Then now sit down. God will start bringing harvest. Is it not Psalm 67 verse 7? Let the people praise thee. Let the people praise thee, O Lord. Then the earth, which means your business, the earth shall yield and increase. And God, even our God, shall bless us. The earth shall yield and increase. Give me verse 6. Start on verse 6. Verse 5. Verse 5. Let the people praise thee, O Lord. Let the people praise thee. Verse 6. Then shall the earth yield and increase. And God, even our own God, shall bless us. And the whole earth shall fear him. Rise on your feet. Sit down. Sit. You see the way you're standing? That means there's an evil load. Rise on your feet. Sit down. Sit. I want us to stand. Sit down. Are you seated? Look at your neighbor. And just talk inside you. Come and see you must be come here. Now rise on your feet. Glory to God. Some people are still sleeping. That's why you have to wake up. In the next 3 minutes. How many minutes? How many? How many? We are going to engage in chronic praise. 3 minutes. Are you ready? You are not. I want praise that is on top. Are you ready to dance? If you don't dance, I will stop it because life is my head. Who is doing it, mama? Who is doing praise? Are you doing it? Good. Are you ready? 3 minutes. I want you to dance, then we give our praise. And after you have given God this praise, believe him that a miracle will happen. That amen, I don't like it at all. That amen is very tired. That amen is infected. Are you ready to dance? Please, we praise God with the dance. We praise God with the song. So I want you 3 minutes. We give God praise. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? One, two, somebody give him a shout! No matter everything. protecting you. Just intervene in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shout a better amen.
Amen.
Very fast, you may take your seat and take your offerings and your tithes. It's time to give. I want to encourage you, go home. Make sure you have time of praise. Make sure you have time for praise. Make sure you have time for praise. Very, very important. Then you make it a habit. You'll be surprised at the breakthroughs you'll see. Glory to God. Quickly, Titus, right on the feet, raise your hand.
If you're
ready with your tithe, walk in front. Father, thank you for every tither. I release blessings over them. Lift up your tongue. I decree blessings that come with tithing. Lord, you say, try me this and see if I will not open the windows of heaven for a blessing that you have no room to keep. You said that if you pay our tithe, you rebuke the devourer. And you say, our vine shall not stop from yielding fruit. And men shall say, we are the blessed of the Lord. Thank you, Father, because that word, Malachi 3, 10 to 18, shall come to pass in everyone's life. Let every tither not struggle financially. Let them experience abundance in every area of their life. I speak blessings. In Jesus' name we pray.
Manawe uko Dania. Manawe uko Dania. Umenifanya.
Father, bless our giving. Bless our offerings. I pray for multiplication of increase. As we give our offerings, we shall not lack. You told us that when we give, you said good measure, pressed down and shaken together,
shall come to us. Lord, we stand on that scripture in the book of Luke chapter 6 verse 38. And let the blessings come even as we give our offerings. It's a portion of what you have given us that you have returned with thanksgiving to honor you and to say we love you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Which way, Pastor? Ashes, how are we doing it? This side, this way? And this way, this way. All right, please tell me. Let's follow our ashes. This side. Those who give the offerings, can they? From this side, bring your offerings. Let's be fast. Rise on your feet. Let's give our offerings. How many people have not filled it? Have not. Let me see your hand. Let me see your hand. You know what to do this way for us. Okay, please don't put it down. Let our ushers give you this. Quickly fill it. And before you leave, leave it to the ushers. Just lift up your hand so they can know where you are and give it to you. Let's help them. Let's be fast with this. Make sure you fill it. And if there's a challenge, kindly. There's a place for number 3, is a place for age bracket. Please, if you're uncomfortable putting your age, then don't disclose. You know, most ladies don't like saying how matured they are. Amen? So if you don't feel like disclosing your level of maturity, it's okay. You can tick where it is. Prefer not to disclose. Everybody has? Who does not have? Le who does not have? You don't have this paper. Okay. Thank you. Lastly, you're here, you're not born again. You are not saved. You say, man of God, I want to give my life to Jesus. At the count of 3, I would like to pray with you. Kindly walk to the front. You're here, you're saying, I am not saved. I would like to be born again. Close your eyes, everyone, please. Please, for 1 minute. You're here, you're not born again. You're saying, I would like to give my life to Christ. Is there anyone like that? Quickly run to the front. Let me pray with you. You're saying, I want to give my life to Christ. God bless you. God bless you. Can you clap for that sister? Please come, come, come. Come. Is there anyone else? Come, come, come. Is there? God bless you, sir. Come, 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 please. Is there somebody else? You're saying, I want to give my life to Christ. Is there anyone? You're not saved. You're saying, I want to give Jesus my life. Is there anybody else? God bless you. Come. Come, come. Come, please. Come, please. Come, please. Come, come. Let's pray for them. Glory to God. Amen. Is there anybody else? You're saying, I want to give my life to Christ, but I want to rededicate my life to Jesus. I was not born again, but I was born again and I backslid, and I want to rededicate my life to Christ. All right, quickly, as we are still standing, can you kneel down, please? Just kneel down. Can I have 2-3 ministers behind them? May I just kneel down? And I want you to repeat this prayer aloud. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I give you my life. I am a sinner in need of your salvation. Forgive me all my sins. From today, come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. Jesus, I cannot do without you. I pray that you sustain me, that I may not fall.
Jesus' name. Amen. Father, I thank you for this beloved. I cover them with the blood of Jesus. I pray as they have given their life to Christ, so shall they be sustained. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak blessings upon them. And let your favor be upon them. In Jesus' name. Amen. Quickly rise up. Thank you so much for giving your life to Christ. Kindly meet Pastor. Follow this pastor for 1 minute. Kindly, can you celebrate God for them? In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. So quickly make sure if you have not taken this, make sure you have it and you make sure you fill it up and leave it with the ushers. Stretch your hands here as we say grace. The Lord keep you, the Lord watch over you. Everything you do will succeed in Jesus' name. The Lord give you favor in the name of Jesus. May you go forward and never go backward. Any attack, any problem in your life is removed in Jesus' name. I pray that whatever you do will succeed in Jesus' name. The Lord bless you, the Lord lift you. You shall never go down, you remain on top. In Jesus' name we pray. Say amen. Now, before we say grace, because of time factor, we might not be able to minister every Sunday. But put it in your mind that we have Tuesday prophetic appointment where it's purely ministration. And again, every last Sunday of every month from 2 to 3 is purely prophetic ministration. But in the service, we'll be doing it 1-2 because of time. But at the same time, we have 2 days just to make sure we minister to you. Because of time, we'll just have those 2 days. Appointment, if you have to come for an appointment on Tuesday, all my appointments are on Tuesday. See Pastor Eric, or you call 0705-899608. That's our church line, and we'll be able to help you. Amen. I will not be seeing anyone who doesn't have an appointment. Are you with me? Our appointments are free, we're not charging. But just to make sure we put proper order and to make sure we are doing the right thing. Amen. Amen. I decree you will not beg, you will not borrow from any man, any bank, or any circle. The Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, and cause his face to shine upon you. I decree over your life, you will go forward every day. And from today, I pray for you that surely goodness and mercy all the days of my life, forever and ever. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Now, if you have a child who is 13 years and above, and you like them to learn music, learn drum set, learn guitar, especially music, kindly make sure you see Pastor Eric and we'll arrange and we'll tell you how it is done. Amen. Please make sure you do that, and the Lord bless you. I love you by force, and I pray that you'll succeed, and I wish you well. Go in peace. You are blessed for life. Amen.